are brought close to God through the blood of Jesus. We've been meditating on what the blood of Jesus has done for us. And this is the way in which we can experience the power of the blood of Jesus. Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 13 tells us, "But now in Christ Jesus, you who were far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ." In the Old Testament, everyone was not allowed to enter into the Holy of Holies, where the very presence of God rested. There was only the high priest who had that privilege, and there was a certain time that he would be allowed to do it in a year, and he couldn't do it all the time. So God, because he's a holy God, he's an awesome God, it wasn't possible for people to just enter his presence as they were. But as we consider what Jesus has done for us on the cross of Calvary, you know, why he shed his blood, we realize that blood was required for people to enter into the presence of God. Or rather, the blood was required even for the high priest to enter into the Holy of Holies. And blood was required for God to commune with man. So this blood has done something powerful. Even the blood of goats and animals in those days has brought man closer to God. But Jesus, being that one perfect sacrifice, has done something immensely great for us. He has brought us near to God. Isn't that the cry of every human heart, to be close to God? And as children of God, what we realize is that the blood of Jesus has granted us access into the presence of God. So every time we approach him, we may just call upon him, or we pray unto the Lord. This is the confidence that we can have at that time, that we have the access to enter his presence only because of the blood of Jesus. It's not anything that we have done, but the blood of Jesus is powerful, granting us access and drawing us closer to God. And even in the book of Hebrews, we realize that Jesus, through his own blood, he has entered the presence of God. He has entered heaven. And so the blood of Jesus has done a powerful work in giving mankind access to Almighty God. And that's the work of the blood. And this day, may we know that any moment we need to approach God, we don't have to feel that we are left out. But if we believe in the Lord Jesus and if we invite him into our hearts we believe in the power of the blood of Jesus, we have access right now into his presence, and we can approach him as our Abba Father, and we can enjoy his presence and make our requests known to him. Shall we just look to God in prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you for your blood, O God, Lord, that has given us access into your very presence. God, we praise you because, God, this is an impossible thing, but you've done it, O God, by shedding your own blood. Father, even today, God, I just speak and declare, God, I just speak and declare for those, Lord, who are in prolonged sicknesses, God, that Father, the power of that sickness over them will be broken off of them. Lord, I declare wholeness. I declare, O God, a strength, and I declare, Father God, complete restoration and recovery from that disease, God. Thank you, God. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your love toward us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.